chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir.
Good morning, Alatoona. I'm Presley Robertson.
And I'm Nick Smith, and you're watching The Anchor.
It's Thursday, November 30th. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and pause for a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now please pause for a moment of silence.
For the rest of the year, we're anchored in holiday cheer here at Alatoona. That means we've got to dress up every day. Today is Grinch versus Whoville, so pick a side and dress accordingly. Friday is Gingerbread versus Candy Cane, so grab your best Candyland-inspired outfit and join in on the fun.
Important information regarding Shop with a Buck. All students accepted as AHS mentors for SWAB should have received their green acceptance letters prior to Thanksgiving break. A few friendly reminders, a minimum donation of $50 is due by Friday, December 1st. Please have your parent complete the CCSD field trip permission form through Parent View. Remember, in order to participate, you must attend one of the SWAB mentor training meetings next week. The first one is Monday, December 4th at 3:45 p.m. The second meeting is Tuesday, December 5th at 7:45 a.m. The third one is Wednesday, December 6th at 3:45 p.m. And the final mentor meeting is Thursday, December 7th at 7:45 a.m. All of these meetings will be held in the theater. Let's go meet up and help area kids have a great holiday.
Retro is popular these days, and we here at The Anchor have been wondering, can we recognize retro items? Our reporters sat down, and a few Alatoona students and staff find out.
Hey Buccaneers, I'm Nick, and this is Dusty.
We're at Alatoona showing people technology from the Dark Ages, also known as the 80s and 90s, and seeing if they can recognize them. Let's get into it.
All right, so we're just gonna need you to say what you think the item is and what it's used for.
Sounds good.
You're actually stupid.
That's a Walkman. It's like it starts with a V, right?
No, that's a Walkman, right?
Well, that item is a certifiable called a Walkman.
That's a Walkman.
Yeah,
there's a Walkman. Let's go.
Yo, that looks like a pager.
I don't know what that is. Is it a calculator?
That's a beeper. Is that a pager?
Yeah.
Oh, it actually.
That item is clearly a beeper or a pager. If I was perhaps a doctor or a lawyer and needed to get a hold up, you could page me by going beep 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 beep, and I would grab it off my hip and see who was trying to get a hold of me.
It's a fax machine.
That's a fax machine. We still have one of those in the front office.
Is that a fax machine?
Well, that's called a fax machine. Now, the cool thing about a fax machine was not only could you place a phone call out on it, but you could also send digital information that would be received almost instantaneously. One of the problems with the fax, though, very easy to lose your data. And you always had to have paper.
I knew that one. I knew that one because I saw it on Friends. My teacher just talked about those last period.
That's a floppy disk.
Those are floppy disks.
Is it a Beyblade?
Is that like an old like emote selector from Fortnite?
Is that a pin? Like pin? What is that?
Pogs! I used to play that game.
Oh, those are iPops or AirPops or something. Pogs. There we go. The Pogs. So they're getting our Pog battle with each other. So, oh, here's my Pog versus your Pog.
It's just, I don't know, pictures of animals on discs.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Okay, these are called Pogs. They were like marbles or Pokemon cards from like the 80s and 90s. Mainly like northern states would play them. So they just like turn them into games and trade them. So.
Yeah, no.
And you'd collect up the Pogs. It's like a newer version of marbles from the 50s.
And dude, I love Pokemon cards. I've never seen Pogs.
They're from like the 80s and 90s.
Oh, that's a Game Boy. I miss my Game Boy.
Oh, that's a Game Boy. I know that. Everybody knows a Game Boy. Didn't know that.
Looks like dog food, bro. What is that?
Is that Scooby Snacks?
Oh, yeah, that looks like some precursor to, like, strange chicken nuggets and barbecue sauce or something along that lines. First, I thought it was some Nutella with pretzels, but looks like chicken nuggies, an earlier version with some kind of kangaroo.
That's a snack. That's a snack, though. I don't know the name of it.
They're called Dunkaroos.
Dunkaroos! Some type of... Wait, Dunkaroos!
Yes!
I know that! What? I know that!
How?
I know that!
How?
I used to be fat, I would eat those. I used to be big when I was a little kid. Yes.
Used to be?
Still there. Okay. And that's all the pictures.
Oh, I actually knew that. That's easy. I mean, that's what I grew up in, so. Is that it?
That was interesting.
Yeah. See you next time and enjoy the rest of your day.
The weather may be cold, but the arts are hot here at Alatoona. I'm Nick Snow, and this is your Anchor Arts Update. Congrats are in order for our region champion one-act performers. They traveled to state and finished in second place. Not only that, but they were the only group that received a standing ovation. All of us from the drama department appreciate the love and support from the Alatoona community. We're glad you enjoyed watching The Miracle Worker as much as we love performing it. Next up this spring, Mary Poppins the Musical. Our annual winter event, the Fine Arts Gala, will be on Tuesday, December 5th from 7 to 10 p.m. in the main gym. It will be a night of music, visual arts, and performances that will help you fall into the holiday spirit. So congrats again to Drama and come out to the gala. It's the season to celebrate Alatoona.
Hey there, are your feet cold? Well then, cover them up with some Buck socks. They're only $10 a set and they make a great holiday gift. All proceeds go to support the transition program. Order yours today on MyPayments Plus.
Need some holiday jammies to go with those socks? How about Buck pajamas? Shirts are $18 and pants are $25. Order by this Friday, December 1st, to ensure they arrive by Christmas.
Who loves Panda Express? If so, come on out this Saturday and eat as much as possible. 20% of all sales on Saturday, December 2nd, go to help our mathletes on the math team. Happy eating.
Winter sports are in season and they're going well. It's time for today's Anchor Sports.
What's up, Bucks? I'm Nick Bull, and I've got all your Alatoona sports news right now. One way we celebrate all things Alatoona is through our exquisite pep rallies. Our reporters attended this fall edition and have it to share.
Never pet a rat, never said a lot. Only what need to be said. Got a little guap when you get a lot. Wanna play you on red. Don't push me, get my feet on the ledge. This game is like follow the leader. If you looking closely enough, then you'll see that I live. The moves that I made, the people I fed, the evil I ducked. Their minds is too feeble, they lean on their crutch. I'm bleeding from fighting my demons head up. When I get defeated, believe I get up. I come from a city, more niggas ain't heard of until they popped in my first CD. Now look, I'm on a Mount Rushmore, you can't front up. Sadly, I can't say the same for you. Same for you. Couple of dollars be changing you names. I pray for you, but 100 million, I'm
still.
Air Rifle sets their sights on another victory today as they compete against those Ridgeland Panthers. Good luck. Basketball travels to Kennesaw Mountain tomorrow for another set of games. Ladies at 6, guys at 7:30. drive on down Kennesaw Due West for a great evening of basketball. Swim and dive competes tomorrow after school at the Cobb Aquatic Center in Marietta. Go get them. Wrestling, travel to Creekview tomorrow and Saturday for an invitational meet. Good luck as you continue your success this season. Flag football, stay tuned for more information about our flag football team as they enter first round of playoffs next week. Go Bucks. Track and field will be holding a season kickoff meeting on Thursday, December 7th at 7 p.m. in the AHS cafeteria. Anyone interested must plan to attend with a parent slash guardian. We will be covering the upcoming season, booster club, and registration. More information will be available at the link on the screen. And that's it for today's Anchor Sports. We'll see you tomorrow.
The student of the day is Connor Derman. Connor comes to class prepared every day and is an active participant in class. He asks good questions and gives his best effort each day. He has a positive attitude and is a conscientious student. Great job. Please go up to the front office during your lunch to receive your reward. And that's all for today, Altoona.
Check back with us tomorrow morning for more.
Thanks for watching and have a smooth sailing day.
On his way, he's loaded lots of toys.